James, many thanks for joining. I'm going to try and grab some of your positivity and share it with a wider community, if that's okay.
Brilliant, yeah, much appreciated, and happy to be here, as I said, and happy to help.
You've represented your country at the highest level. What attributes are transferable from the sporting world into the business world in terms of high performance?
I think two things really stand out for me is I think the philosophy around goal setting and very goal orientated. And then the second thing is the ability to work on a team. Now, I obviously come from an individual sport, but there's a wider team there. There's a coach, there's a support network. And I think sports people generally, not always, but generally work well on a team.
So, why is it they work better on a team?
Yeah, I think in terms of achieving the goal, in terms of working well together effectively, I think in terms of performance, that mindset, I think from speaking to and from being a sports person myself, is that, look, you know that you're not an expert in everything, and you have to try and leverage the different people's strengths on the team to be effective and to be successful.
And you mentioned the attributes of being driven in nature. Is that something that's inherent that you're sort of brought up with, or is that something you believe you can develop in individuals?
Yeah, it's a really good question. I mean, I think my philosophy has always been it's really important about who you surround yourself with. For kids, I think a coach is so important. I mean, when I was young, I was very lucky to have a great coach who was very positive, very supportive, had our group reading books of non-sports people, of business people. I mean, it had a huge impact on my life. And then I look at, you know, in the corporate world when I work with teams now, and you see how important that leader or mentor or coach or whatever person you want to call them, just how important it is to have someone who's in your corner and supporting you and I suppose driving you forward. There's a quote from Tony Robbins said, success leaves clues, and you know, I think mentors and people you can ask for advice are important.
How do you maintain your positivity and your motivation?
Yeah, that's a very good question. I've thought about this a lot. You know, values and what's important to you. For me, happiness is important, fun is important. I want to get out of bed and do something that I want to do. Now, obviously, there's days where, you know, some days are tougher than others. I'm not going to sit here and say not, but I think when the goal or when the vision is clear, then you can really go after that purpose or that goal. My philosophy would be, look, life is short. You may as well do something you want to do. We never know what's around the corner.
Great attitude, and I don't think any of us saw the current circumstances coming around the corner. You touched upon bad days there. What's your approach to them?
I see it almost as being, there's almost like a reset button when you get into kind of a spiral of maybe not being in a good space, that it's almost that internal dialogue. I suppose my philosophy or my mindset is, okay, I wake up tomorrow morning and it's a new day. I sit down and I write out what I want to achieve for the day, or what are the key points for the day that I want to achieve. And then I kind of have the philosophy that, you know, I need to go again now, obviously perform. But I think a big thing for me is planning the day. So plan the day and then go after it.
You mentioned earlier your support network and, you know, surround yourself by positive people.
You know, you mentioned obviously Branson and he's obviously one of the people I've met, but I've met so many incredible business people and people in general in Ireland and everywhere. And look, we all have times where we're struggling a little bit with things, and it's really important that you have people that you can reach out to. You know, like my philosophy is I believe in people. I believe in the goodness of people. And I think, without sounding kind of hairy-fairy, but like when I retired from professional tennis, I really didn't know what I wanted to do, but I went out and met people for coffees, or, you know, I spoke to business people who played tennis, and I said, look, is there any way you could give me half an hour of your time? And by and large, people are very obliging. And if someone messaged me and said, could you meet for a coffee? I'd be open to having a conversation with someone. And I think generally people are.
You know, you've been very generous in agreeing to this.
Your interviewing is better than your tennis anyway.
What's your approach to goal setting and working towards achieving your goals?
What is the big goal that you're trying to achieve? What is the overriding vision? And then what are the small things that you can do on a daily basis that's going to help you achieve that goal? So it's what is the vision, and then work backwards from that. I finished playing tennis, the executive coach that I met, he said to me, if we were having this coffee in 3 years' time, what would you be doing? So, and I remember thinking, geez, I have no idea. For me, it's getting up in the morning and what are the small details, what are the small things that I can do on a daily basis that's going to help me hit that vision or that goal.
Where did you get your inspiration from?
Tennis has been very good to me, and that the people that I've met, like tech entrepreneurs, and spending time with Richard, he's been inspirational to me to be able to have cups of tea with him and have chats and be in email dialogue with him. I've been very lucky, but at the same time, I would also say that, like, when you spend a lot of time with him, you also see that, like, he's just a person as well, you know, and he's got his, you know, he's not God or something, and you can learn a lot from different people. So I remember at an event I hosted, I asked the group of CEOs, I said, do people here have a mentor? And one of the CEOs said, no, I don't have a mentor, I have mentors. One business person I met on Necker, actually, her name is Dr. Betty Uribe. She wrote a book called Values. She asked me the question. She said, who's on your internal boardroom? Which I thought was quite powerful. She was like, look, companies have their boardrooms, they have their non-execs, they have their chairmen and so on. But who are the people, who's on your board? Who are the people supporting you? So, yeah, if you take one thing from this, I would say go ahead and find someone to help you.
There's a bit of advice that you can pass on, a bit of positivity. What would it be?
Staying positive and saying, you know, there's no kind of magic bullet, I guess. And one of my favorite quotes would be, control the controllables. Like, what can you control? And to get into a good routine of, you know, maybe doing something like yoga or meditation or something in the morning, but just to try and get into that mindset or that frame of mind.
You're about to become a published author this summer. What can we expect in that?
Yeah, I suppose the theme of the book really is the lessons from sport and business to achieve your goals. I've just met so many incredible people through tennis, you know, top tennis players in the world. And then obviously since then, spending some time on Necker, coaching Richard. But then not only that, but the people that you meet around him, the people that come through the island. I've met some incredible people. Like, I would love someone to read the book and feel like they could take something back into their daily life to help them move forward in terms of their goals and performance.
What's the best book you've read recently?
I'm reading a book actually at the moment, The Art of Civilized Conversation, which is around expressing yourself as an individual, so in business or personal settings. So I'm enjoying that. I finished Shoe Dog, Phil Knight, but Phil Knight, who started Nike. It's a really interesting story and the kind of the risk he took.
Any sort of motivational videos, TED Talks you've watched recently?
There's a guy, Evan Carmichael, I don't know if you've ever heard of him. He puts the top 10 kind of quotes from a person. I love the one from Tony Robbins where he tells the story about how Stallone wrote Rocky and how he brought Rocky to life.
So finally, give me one of your favorite quotes.
My favorite quote, well, I speak a lot about John Wooden, who is the legendary UCLA basketball coach. His quote around success is peace of mind, which is a direct result of self-satisfaction in knowing you did the best to become the best you're capable of becoming. So basically, he was like, look, success is not winning and losing. Success is not, it's what's your absolute best. So for me as a tennis player, I was 145 in the world. Was I successful? Look, I pretty much did the best I could do. I'm pretty content with that. You know?
As I mentioned, you do a lot of motivational speaking coaching. If someone wanted to get in touch with you.
So I'm currently doing a lot of one-to-one coaching remotely as well. So my website is hccollective.co. And then my email address is j.klusky@hccollective.co. If anyone needs anything, just let me know.
Many thanks for your time and sharing your positivity when we most need it.